Boo! What's up, ladies and gentlemen? My name's Seth, and we're back again for another trove. Ah! Been a long time since we did the normal flute thing. Today, we are doing a world tour of Team Pixel because the club has been growing exponentially. It's been going absolutely... Do you think some classes will receive buffs? I don't know the Mighty Rumble. Hello, Coco and Xiao Dox and Patriot Assassins. Anyways, we're doing a world tour because the club has been growing like crazy. We are on King Andrew's house. Most people don't even know who he is anymore, but I know a lot of you old school fans know. Rest in pepperoni, King Andrew. Rest in the pepperoni. Also, Johnny added this in honor of King Andrew, who played the piano on this deck and he fell. So that kind of added a little bit of roleplay to why he's dead. Because we have like graves dedicated to him all over the place.
My name is Bowser the Sky Whale.
What? You're the Sky Whale?
Yes, and I demand that we get to 20 likes.
Oh no, everybody better do what he says, otherwise we're gonna be in trouble. But anyway, over there, don't even, just ignore that. That's something Ricket's working on right now. He's been building like crazy, as well as Scrawly has been building like crazy. So first of all, let us head towards, let's head in this direction. Let's go towards all this lava and stuff like that. So over here, you're going to notice in this biome over here that I cleared out, since the last time we did world tour anyway, I cleared out what was in the middle of this wall and area. I should definitely put a boot on. I need to put a boot on instead of our beautiful little Samantha. Oh my goodness. So I cleared this out because I want to eventually, when I can find the time, make this into a trial temple. So this whole area is going to kind of be focused on trials and stuff like that. So right here, for example, we have our own version of Lava Runners because there's no official way to do it. What Lava Runners was originally is there is a dungeon in the lava biome that you can sink under the lava. It's got a huge pool of lava. And as the lava is coming down, we try to like get to the other side and back before the lava comes down. But it's very, very slow and you can't really program something like that in the game over and over. So instead, I just made our own version of Lava Runners where you have to try and get across this with one jump through the whole thing, just getting across it with one jump, no cheating or anything like that. If you touch the lava, you can restart, but you can just keep going because who cares. And then this part's a little bit tricky where you actually get to the top. I kept saying that I wanted to actually have this platform all the way up to the volcano, but honestly, I don't think so. More realistically, I think I would probably make a different platforming course up the side of the volcano or something like that. But it looks like somebody's trying to build a house over here. I haven't actually seen this. I wonder who built this. I like it. That's kind of cool. As far as I know, no one's built anything inside this lava volcano. Nope, doesn't look like it. There was something over here a long time ago, but it looks like it actually got grieved. That kind of sucks. Because we had a griever randomly, that's another reason that architect is extremely... This is a secret base to the nightmare, aren't you, if you dare... Okay, it's not here anymore. Somebody destroyed it. But that's why we've been so tight with Architect lately. Now we're kind of considering it where it's like, Architect is kind of like on a time limit. So it's like, if you have a build that you want to do, if you are a trusted enough player and you've been around long enough, then yes, you can get Architect so that you can make a build. But then once you're actually finished with that build, we're probably going to demote you back down. So anyway, there is this skull over here. I forget who built this one. I honestly don't know. I hope this sign says, do not touch the teeth. They hurt. It's Scrawly. Okay. And it looks like he's building something underneath here. So I wonder if this connects anywhere. Because I know another thing that secretly is going on right now. I don't know where they all are. But somebody has been building, like Johnny Ricket has been doing it as well. Where they're building like an underground dwarven city type thing. So that's going to be really, really cool. Another thing that I would love to see taking up some space, which Ricket's doing over there, is he's going to build a big moon base. So I want to start taking up more of the sky area, like the whale up there. So this frost area, this was pretty cool. Oh, it looks like it's developed a little bit more too. This was by Silent Death. who I wonder if he's been building for a little while longer. I'm going to have to check architect status because I know that we've been demoting a lot of people just because it's been so crazy lately that we haven't been able to keep up. But anyway, it seems like he developed a couple more houses, so that's cool. He ended up making a temple up here. It had a staircase. He got rid of it. Not exactly sure why. I guess he didn't really want it. But either way, I really like it. He tried to make it more like in theme with what we got going over in our whole theme of the club and stuff like that. Over here was the members area, but it was getting griefed a little bit too hardcore. But I do know that Rickett has a secret little house right down here that he's going to try and connect this pipeline. Let's call it a pipeline, even though it's caves. Here's his little igloo house. And we're going to try and connect this to the rest of the dwarven, like, stuff that we got going on. I guess he's just putting these blocks all around just because why not? It's all, like, stuff that he keeps using for builds. But pretty cool, man. Like, I really like the way that the club is progressing. The club world itself has expanded out quite a bit. That's because a lot of people have been giving me different biomes and stuff like that. But personally, I would like to, like, I prefer it if we can keep this club smaller rather than bigger. Because there's a lot of big clubs already in Trove. And I like the fact that ours is very small and very, like, community-based, even though we still have a lot of members and a lot of props and stuff like that, you know? And I think that's another reason why everybody likes this club so much, because we all, it's kind of more of a hangout club, you know? Nothing really too hardcore or anything like that. Looks like somebody made a doorway into this cactus. Anyway, this was millions of years ago. That was done by Yoko. The Vile Scallywag Pirate was done by Sithis a million zillion years ago. It's pretty cool. We'll show you that in a minute. It's a ride. And then over here, we just got, this was Yoko and Mighty Joe ended up building this little village. And then a bit of it ended up getting griefed, unfortunately. So that's a little bit too bad. We'll skip over the Tron biome for now, just so we can go over into this area. We do have this empty biome right here has a secret to it. And all this stuff on the top was done by Cookie Knight. And Scrawly is actually building a gigantic Donkey Kong right there. That's what we always call him, because I honestly don't know what he's called. I think he's called, like, Dreamy or something. Here's some pinata ruins that he ended up building, so that's really cool. And he's got spikes around, so it's like barbed wire. That's another one by Scrawly. He also ended up building this man-made tree. He put a Team Pixel thing here. And I love Team Pixel, so I made this. Scrawly, thanks, Scrawly! And then on the other side, this is cool because we're starting to get some games up in here. So this is very neat. This is actually a platform zone area. We won't have enough time to do this today. But if we start right here, and you can do the whole thing with one jump. Ah! My movement speed is too intense right now, though. So it's honestly a bit too hard to do. Oh! But you can actually, like, I didn't even know you could make jumps like the one that we just did right there. Like, seriously, it's... Ugh! Whoop! Okay, let's see if we can do this. Yeah, we're supposed to be able to do this with one jump. So, you know what? Even though I said we wouldn't, screw it. Let's just cheat. So anyway, you go up here, you go back around this way, and then you climb up here, and then you win. Victory, there you go. I wonder what he's doing with that tree. I'm not sure yet. But he's building that Dreamy or whatever. And then over here, this ended up getting grieved like crazy. This was Rage Kill's build. It was supposed to be a secret hot dog base. Very, very cool idea. Too bad people didn't want to play ball because the force field is down. It has been destroyed. I think it looks better this way because I take it into, like, as a role play, it's kind of like the hot dogs were attacked. And that's, like, let's just say that the dragons attacked the hot dog. And that's why we're hiding in the dragon pajamas so that they don't kill us and eat us. Also, this lava over here because Rage is trying to build with, I think, Squid. They're trying to build like a big dragon airport or something like that over here. He also has a secret right here. You can actually, if you're the Fae and you have your teleport, you can jump, teleport in there. And then there's like a couple secret signs in there. But otherwise, it's the head of this dinosaur. Dinosaur, yeah. It's the head of the dragon. Whoa, looks like somebody's been grieving up here. Wonder what that's about. Unless that was Rage Kill, probably by accident. I don't know if it was him per se, but I know he's been flying around with his dragon a lot. Ooh. I don't like that somebody destroyed these trees. This could have also been very, very old because we haven't actually gone through every single inch of the club world since the Griever ended up hitting. But anyway, let's go back down this way a little bit. So we actually have, I'll just show you this off anyway because why not show you all the little secrets that we got going on. So down here, Almost nailed it. Let's roll right into it, because that's the easiest way to get in. This is Polka Guy's little house, as far as I know. Yes? Yes. Yes, it is. It even leads to, I think that's his club world, Dragon Builders or something. I don't know. But anyway, cool little house he's got going on. And then over here, I want to show you all this, because, somebody took the middle of the X. That's a little bit weird. X marks the spot. I thought that was such a cool idea. But it'd be cool if you could set things up. There's a sign in there. It'd be cool if you could set things up where it's like people could dig, but the blocks would kind of reset themselves or something. Anyway, if you come to the corner of these two biomes and dive right in, here, right here, is a secret passage to the hot dog base where the barrier ended up being destroyed. So we won't actually cover that today, but you can go check it out for yourself. Over here, I've sectioned off this area because High Lord Jash is big, big responsible for all this. He ended up building in here a long, long time ago. And so we sectioned this whole area off because why not? You know, that's kind of the way it goes. If the builds end up getting cool enough that we don't want people messing with them, because he kind of just claimed this whole biome for himself and people started like attacking his TV and everything like that. So we wanted to clear it all out. Clear it all out, as in like get people so that they couldn't grieve it or anything like that. Then over here in the Candyland biome, it's pretty empty, very, very dead. You'll know why in a minute. But we got a fishing hole here, so that's okay. Also, you can see all these houses that I'm still in the middle of constructing. They may end up being up by the time we're by the time this video goes up. I honestly don't know, though. I haven't had that much time for building. Anyway, we got this portal here, and I explained this in an episode, I think, unless I explained it today and I'm all over the place. But this is actually dedicated to Sithis. It goes to his club world, and I want to remove this mountain and have, like, a big portal house. And that house is going to have, like, kind of cool things like this, like little pixel art things that kind of emphasize, like, what's in a club and stuff like that. So I'm going to have to try and work that out. Here's our pinata pit right here, which it looks like people put the bouncing balls in there. Here's our main house, which has been upgraded a little bit, not too much, since the initial build. It ended up turning out so cool that we haven't barely touched it. We only fixed up the center is a little bit different than the original version because Sithis accidentally bombed it once and it was time to change it anyway, so it's all good. Also added these chains to the side, so now people aren't getting caught every time they're trying to boost up to all of our portals. Sky portal is over here because U6 is now there. And then also, of course, there's this as well. I don't know if I showed this on camera. I just made a more open area right here, and these are all the other club areas. I think there might even be like two scallywags. I don't know, but this goes to like all the other like really cool portals, club worlds and stuff like that. But anyway, we'll go over to there in a minute. I guess we won't get to touch Sithis's ride, but if you just go over to that skull yourself, you can check it out for yourself. Also, here is the V for victory. This is for the Quibsley hunt and all the people that are winning there. I also put this up recently. This is like the AFK tent where you can hang out and have some chicken and stuff like that. People don't really sacrifice the pinatas in there, but that's mainly because I don't really buy pinatas. But we'll go over here in a minute because this is actually, I'm quite proud of the build that happened. You know what? Let's just do it now. And then we'll get to the oceans and stuff in a bit. Because this is going to be a longer video just because of how much the club has actually grown. So anyway, if you go out this side, the south side, which I always think is like the east side because you always appear in this club like this or like this. Or I don't even know. But anyway, this was Tiny Town. And I've changed it because first it was all of this, and also right here you can see this house is dedicated to Louis Plays, because we're actually giving away like houses to members and stuff throughout our streams and just videos and stuff like that. But anyway, this was the first little village that I ended up building. Actually, the real first one was up in those trees, which you can go check that out yourself because honestly, I mean, we've already covered it and it's not that impressive. It's just kind of like whatever. But I ended up also, this bridge used to just be solid green, and then I made it like the white and gold just to fit with King Andrew's stairway from a million zillion years ago. But anyway, Tiny Town has expanded. This area is nothing new, but this is where I do my gardening and stuff. Why are those fences gone? Because they just didn't want to appear, that's why. And also, we've expanded Tiny Town out like crazy. By the way, there's a house right there and there's a castle right there that leads to someone's club world. Very cool club world, I just gotta say. So anyway, you can kind of see that this is where it all started. And then I expanded it out. So we come over this way and this is kind of where it all comes out. I now leaving Tiny Town. Oh, okay. I changed the sign, I guess. Even though it's not, it's leaving Tiny Town, but Tiny Town has still expanded. So all of this is all new. At least as far as like shown in a video and stuff like that. So we got all these houses over here. It took me so long to build all this, but I just got in a crazy building mood. Like that's kind of how it is. When I get an idea for a project, then I just go for it like crazy for a couple days until it's finished, you know? Same with when I ended up making the gigantic sky whale. I was building him constantly until he was done. But anyway, you come over here and I just made houses, nothing but houses. What? So many houses. I filled up this entire biome with houses. And you can actually go into all of these. They are not furnished or anything like that. They may be eventually someday, but honestly, I don't really care to, because it's more about just having all of them around rather than having them all around with the extra little detail. Plus, it would cost like so much vermicite to furnish all of this stuff. But anyway, this was the park that was made a million zillion years ago by Mighty Joe. And I changed it. It had a wall all the way around it. I destroyed the wall, left the fountain because I still really like it. Portal goes to his club world, so we can leave that right there. But anyway, I still have a sign right there too that says that the fountain was made by Mighty Joe. So he still gets a shout out for his original build and stuff. But otherwise, I changed it all, made water around and, you know, made all these like main entrances so that it's kind of like the center of the town. Because I really like that idea. Here we got the dojo, of course, which took me ages. I kind of wanted to, like, what this was a project just for myself to see if I could make a house that was better than the starting house. And it's a lot more impressive, that's for sure, but it's not as cool to hang out. Like, everyone still hangs out in the hub one, because that's where we kind of got everything. I didn't want this to ever become, like, a second hub or anything like that. Not until Trove actually has, like, proper portaling where you can actually teleport from one end of the club world to the other. That would be great. But anyway, stole this Yin Yang from, I think it was Shadow of Mordor. I think his club ended up having this. And Sithis actually had a pretty cool floor down here. He still is responsible for all the side stuff that's all over the walls and everything like that, helping to give it kind of a Lunar Ronin feel. But I felt that the yin-yang needed to be down at the bottom here because it's a training dojo, right? And I still, of course, have, like, made by me and Sithis. But then you go over here, and I changed it a little bit. So now there is actually, like, an archery yard. And I made this hill, like, I kind of destroyed it down a bit. And I feel that this is really, really cool. I really like the way that this looks. I just added this pole in recently, too, just to kind of, like, be, like, roleplay that it's holding it up. Here's a training rock that you can train on to beat it up. Here's a house that I was testing out furnishing. So you can kind of see here, I ended up putting a couple veggies down there. And inside it, there's just, like, equipment and chests and stuff like that. And it turned out pretty cool. I would like to have little details like this throughout the whole village. But at the same time, the village itself is very, very, very cluttered with houses. So you gotta be very careful about that. Because I don't want to, like, one of the things that I know a lot of other people do with their builds is they overcomplicate it. And I don't want to put like a million zillion things in the town if it's going to make it very fatiguing for the eyes. Because right now it's already pretty cool and pretty impressive, honestly, to just see all the houses and stuff like that. Also, we have a little robot here who's trying to warm himself up by the fire. And this cave is not fully constructed yet, but it does go all the way through to Aerial Village. I don't know who made this thing. This is kind of cool. Someone was working on this too. This was going to be these Elysian flasks. It looks like there's a bunch of class changes and stuff here too. So I guess somebody worked on that. This is Ario Village. This was built by Snakeshot, Red Ninja, and Johnny ended up, I think, helping with the castle and not much else. I think Snakeshot did the majority of all of this. But maybe it was with Red Ninja. I'm not exactly sure. Anyway, normally there was a pathway that came like through all the trees up to here. But the Griever ended up hitting that. So another reason why we had to kind of take the grieving down. As far as this town goes, it's pretty much done. This house right here, by the way, this used to be the Pit of Sorrow. And now it is like a weird lava house. Because why not? Just because it's kind of cool. This house gets a bit hot. But let's just call it the Sorrowful House or something. The House of Tears. The House of Melting Tears. And over here, I haven't had time to construct this, but this is going to be another type of, let's call it a shop area. So I want to end up putting like a bunch of like buildings and junk like that around, not buildings, like registers and stuff like that. So people can come in here and trade in roleplay and stuff like that. So it's kind of like a supermarket, I guess. So it's not going to be nearly as tall or big or intimidating as the dojo or anything like that. It's just going to probably be this and then the roof. And then it's just going to be a house that I'm probably going to take a little bit more time to detail. Anyway, that was over. This little tower thingamabob was done by Yoko and Mighty Joe again. This, I'm pretty sure, was done by Qubit a zillion years ago. And then it ended up getting hit by the griefer. We kind of cleared it up a little bit, but you can see like on the side right there, like how the walls are kind of messed up a little bit. And oh, maybe somebody fixed it. Yeah, looks like somebody fixed it. So that's nice. Maybe, oh, see like right there in that chain right there. So too bad that that ended up happening. Whatever, oh well. Nothing else that goes over there. Hello, Devil Squire. Here's Nintendo Joe's Rainbow Pyramid, which has a secret around it, but I will not spoil it because, I already did. But anyway, let's see. Do we have enough jump too? Because what other people have been building up here, which is really, really cool, is if you come up here, it is kind of like a airborne dock town. So we have one balloon right here. Very, very cool. I like the looks of it. I like this idea. I love it. I think that would be the next step. There's TX's thingamabob, by the way. It would be really, really cool if people kept this build idea going throughout the club. Like, I would love to have airships in the club. That would be so cool. Because one of the things that we definitely already have with the club is we already have the main area covered, except for Candyland, which I'm gonna move into and start building onto on top of later and stuff like that. But we have like, we have most of the main area covered. We now need to start covering the sky, which I'm glad Rickett is going to be building something in the sky. And there is also the secret underground area, which by the way, that's right, I didn't go there yet. I'm not exactly sure where all the secret holes are though. Anyway, over here is Mighty Joe. Did Joe set these spikes up to keep people away? Anyways, this was done by Mighty Joe and Yoko a long time ago too. Very, very cool house. I made the pathway go up and over there. Also, if you come to the back here, I think this is the official way in. Haven't actually made any paths or anything continuing down here. I want to kind of make houses continuing down here too. But of course, when it gets to stuff like that, like the tricky part is that when builds end up getting cool enough, I have to section off the area. Because otherwise people end up destroying them. I know a lot of kids will come in and they start, like, they might see this crystal and they might not be able to craft it themselves, so they destroy it just so that they can use it. So, yeah. But anyway, if you come in through here, this is Pirate Cove. I should actually have a sign up to it, but whatever. So this is Pirate Cove. This was done a million zillion years ago. Oh, I forget who built this. Shout out to him. Was it Qubit or was it somebody else? Was it Craftmaster? That's right, Craftmaster did it. So this, I kind of wanted this for quite some time. I came here and I kind of saw the idea. There was like normally a huge mountain right here, but we all bombed the crap out of it so that we could end up building this. And even though it only has like one house and stuff, it's Docktown. Like, I like it. I think it's really, really cool. Looks like somebody, yeah, someone changed this up a little bit. This was Mighty Joe's like little dedication house. I think there's actually a secret entrance to the dwarven area through here, but we'll continue onward first. There was through this cave, and the griefer ended up stealing all these torches and rearranging where they were and stuff like that. But I ended up coming through and putting them back around. That is a secret waterfall that goes back outside. And then if we keep coming this way, you can't really see it from this side because it looks a little bit goofy, but there's a skull that I ended up putting. Kind of, and let's just say he's puking you out, right? Like, he's a skull, you know? Someone's also building a, I don't know what this is, I think that's going to end up being a dungeon. And then over here, we actually have a hedge maze that is, as far as I know, completely functional. So if you want to check that out, you can go over into this corner as well. Oh, somebody has built over in this Fae biome. I didn't think anybody did, because I haven't been over here in a million zillion years, because these areas are a little bit too far away from the main area for me to bother going to. But looks like somebody built a little tower thing. I don't know. Then there's a ship here, which I think was built by Squid, I think, a million zillion years ago. Honestly, I don't remember. So much ocean out here because GameDark was trying to. These are all Treasure Island biomes. They really need to change it so that it guaranteed generates a island, you know, because otherwise it's all just ocean. We have Shadow of Mordor's ship over here. He hasn't played in quite a while, so I might have to finish it myself just so we got one ship in the club. Then there's the little beach here with a nice little cave. I love this generation right here. Actually, with that brown, with the gray right there, it kind of looks like an eye, and that's the mouth. There's a couple little houses over there, but we've already been over there. Game Dark was building over here. But I'll have to, again, I'm going to have to check who we have as architect, because I wonder if we actually demoted him before he could actually finish this. Oh, no, it looks like he already got it. Okay, cool. That's neat. I like that. I really like that. That's really cool. Because we need stuff like this, you know? Like, these little things are what I like. Where was the other area that we were going to go to? I think that's pretty much it. Because the biome that's just on top of us is the one that Ragekill is going to make all the dragon stuff in. And that's not actually finished yet. So anyway, the last... Well, not really the last. You know what? We'll go to the dance club in a minute. Because I think that over here is one of the secret entrances. I think that this is the way in. I was half watching Johnny. Yeah, okay. So this is one of the ways in to the secret dwarven city. So right here, there is just table and chairs. That's pretty much it. Also, we're trying to slowly over time, like all these tunnels eventually are going to be like interconnecting to all the other places in the club. So you're going to be able to get around the entire club while being completely underground. I'm not going to continue down there though, because it's actually quite a long walk. But instead, we will continue over here. And last but not least, I'm sure that I'm missing something, but that's okay. You go into that grave and then you continue on through here. This is the new way. Well, not really new anymore, but this was the old way into the dance club, sealed off. It is the fountain that's up top, but now you actually go into that grave, which seems a lot cooler. You know, that's like so awesome. And you come out of the frog hole mouth and you come into here, and here's the dance club that Sithis and me ended up building. Sithis had built this VIP room. He loves these dance floors, this dance floor that he made. He loves it so much that it's actually in his club, Vile Scallywags. So you can always check that out by typing /join world, Vile Scallywags. Or there it is, Vile Scallywags. Yup. And you can put a space in the name too. And then this is the dance room that I ended up making. And this kind of looks like the Windows logo, but it's not. And then there's these, which you can ride around in circles like crazy for a time portal. You can also go up here and go around in circles that way. But either way, that's going to be it for today's tour, ladies and gentlemen. So I'm sure that I probably missed something. Probably didn't give a proper shout out to somebody for their build. But either way, that's it. So as the world is filling up with houses that are dedicated to more and more people, it's getting really, really cool. The club is growing. Loving it. Keep building, everybody that is building. For a lot of people that keep asking, by the way, how you get architect, like I said, we were hit by a griefer pretty hard on some of the other builds. None of the officer builds or anything like that, because I keep those all safe and tidy for myself. But a lot of other people were getting grief. We never found out who the griefer was, otherwise they would be kicked from the club immediately. Because they kept destroying things and then saying it was the Pinata army attacking, which, easy, man. It's just for fun. But anyway, we couldn't end up finding out who the griefer was. And then in general, the member area was getting destroyed like crazy. So as the club has been expanding in members, because I think we're at, like, how many members are we at right now? 728 people. That's crazy, man. No wonder everyone's online all the time. But anyway, because of that, architect is kind of on lockdown right now and kind of a more temporary status. So it's kind of like when you're done your build, you lose architect, and then you can get it back every time you do end up doing more builds, except for a few very specific people. But anyway, that's gonna be it. So thank you all so much for watching. I really do appreciate it. Let's go to Bowser the Sky Whale just so that we can end the episode. Whee! Go up there. Yes. We'll go right up here, just so we can end the episode. You can go into his mouth, or you can go up here to the secret hot dog base thing that fights against the pinatas. But anyway, thanks so much for watching. I would really appreciate it if you would smack that like button, share, favorite, and subscribe to join Team Pixel Sino, and stay epic, everybody. Believe in yourself. Don't care.